Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an Muhammed Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammed Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala s-salah. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. Allah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ على محمدٍ وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمدٍ وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we ask His help and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil inside us and from the evil consequences of our bad actions. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no God to be worshipped but Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our master, our teacher, our leader, the Prophet of Allah. Brothers and sisters, love is truly a powerful, unique, irresistible force. Sometimes when we try to express our love, we find it so hard to find the right words. And even when we come up with some expressions and some words to describe that love, still, we don't feel that these expressions represent how we feel. We don't feel that these words don't really represent or fully represent what is burning deep down in our hearts. And this may explain how we sometimes associate love with actions and not just words. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, إِنَّ الْمَحَبَّةَ لَا تُحَدُّ وَلَا يُعْرَفُ لَهَا تَعْرِيفٌ. He said that love has no definition. Love is this feelings that you have for the beloved that will drive you to do anything to please that person. And speaking of love, brothers and sisters, today is the 10th of Rabi'ul Awwal, the month of the birth of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one whose birth gave humanity a cause to rejoice. The month of the birth of the chosen one, the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him necessary to all mankind in this life and the next life. Our need for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this world is more important and is stronger than our need for food, water, or even air. Our need for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the next life is even more crucial, because he will be the first one to intercede and the first one whose intercession will be accepted on that critical day. Rabi'ul Awwal is the month of the birth of the best human being to have ever walked the earth, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's traditionally known, brothers and sisters, that there are three reasons for love: al-jamal, wal-kamal, wal-ihsan. There are three reasons for love. Number one is beauty, the physical appearance. And it's just a human nature. When you see beauty, you recognize it. And you feel attached to that beauty. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was described by many people, Sahaba, the companions, people who grow up with him, family members, like his children, and his wife's. The most famous description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given by Hind ibn Abi Hala, who was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's stepson, the son of Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha from a previous marriage. He described the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a beautiful way, because he lived in a household of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But maybe when you read his description about the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we feel that he might be exaggerating, just because he lived with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about someone who just lived a few years with him, like Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, who lived only a few years with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was so handsome, كأن الشمس تجري في وجهه, as if the sun was running across his face, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Maybe he's also exaggerating. He lived with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam for all these years. But what about a person that spent a couple of hours with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, didn't even know that was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Meccan guy that everybody's talking about, didn't even know that he was a prophet, Ma'bad, a woman that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed by her tent on his way to Medina sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When her husband came back, she described what she saw. She said, "I've seen a man who is the most handsome, the most beautiful, and striking from close up. The most beautiful and striking from far, from distance, and the most beautiful and handsome from close up." But you know what? Beauty is not the only reason why we love. Sometimes you see beauty, but without any substance. Al-Fadl ibn Rabi' was one of the students of Imam al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu. And this man, subhanallah, he had an unpleasant physical appearance. He was asked to meet with Harun al-Rashid once. It was that bad that Harun al-Rashid had to turn his face. And he said to him something that I won't say. And then this man said, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, inna Allah lam yujillu Yusuf alayhi salam li husni manzarihi, wala li jamalihi, walakin li khuluqihi wa taharatu qalbihi." He said to him, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, O Prince, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not honor the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam because of his beauty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him because of his manners, because of his character, because of his purity, because of the state of his heart." You know, as the poet said, "Laysa al-jamalu bithiyabin tuzayyinuna, innal jamala jamalu al-ilmi wal-adabi." He said that the beautiful person is not the one who adorns or beautifies himself with beautiful garments. The beautiful person is the one who possesses knowledge and manners. And so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of all mankind. He was praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his character. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. That you have the best personality. And he sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself described the purpose of his prophethood and the method of his call when he said, "Innama bu'ithtu li utammima makarim al-akhlaq," that I have been sent, that I was sent to perfect the good manners. And because he himself sallallahu alayhi wasallam possessed his qualities, it was easy for him to recognize his qualities in others, Muslims and non-Muslims, people who fought him in battle sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When they brought him Sufana bint Hatim al-Ta'i, a woman that she was captured and brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, she fought Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He recognized her from her last name. And her father, Hatim al-Ta'i, was known for his generosity. He said, "Khallu sabilaha," let her go. "Fawallahi inna abaha kana rajulan yuhibbu makarim al-akhlaq." Her father was a man who valued good character, a man who valued good traits and manners. Let her go. He forgave sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He had these incredible, incredible qualities: forbearance and forgiveness, compassion and mercy. And the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they witnessed that in him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They saw how he endured patience in a time of hardship. And so it was easy for some of them to adopt all these characteristics. Because good manners, brothers and sisters, is contagious. As one of the Azhari scholars, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon him, Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda, a Syrian scholar from Aleppo. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the people in Halab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him victory very soon, inshallah. This man, subhanallah, he was an Azhari scholar. He graduated from Al-Azhar in Egypt, and he went back to Syria, and he died in 1997. He said, there are two things that are contagious: diseases and good manners. So if you are in a company of people with good traits, you will learn from them. You will pick their status, their manners, their qualities. You will learn from their characteristics. So it's really, really contagious. Aisha radiallahu anha, when she was asked about him, she said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. She was asked by a few young people, how was the personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She said, his character was a Quran, which means he was a Quran walking on earth. He was an open book. He was the embodiment of revelation. He was in a complete movement towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you know what? Having good character without living it is not enough. And that will take us to a higher cause of love, which is ihsan. So again, there are three reasons for love: jamal, beauty, kamal, character, and ihsan. To put it in practice, and let me put it that way. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala felt pity on the condition of the world, He sent them someone, He would improve their misery and relieve their distress and release their problems. Someone who would forgive their mistakes and worry about their guidance. Someone who will fight for the oppressed and speak up against the oppressor. And that was Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He took his people, and subhanallah, he turned them around in an unbelievably short period of time. He took them from being polytheist to being monotheist. He took them from being disbelieving, or from disbelieving in life after death, towards life that the purpose of it will drive you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what He has prepared for you in the next life. He took them from being in a nomadic tribal culture where there was no law or the law of the jungle, and He took him to a society that is governed by principles of fairness and equality and justice. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters, was the first man in the history of mankind to articulate the principles of human rights, the principles of equality between men and women. Our beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the beloved of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was the first man in the history of mankind to establish a constitution where people from different faith traditions, people from different ethnicity and different backgrounds, shared the same exact rights as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslims. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the first one to lay out a foundation of human rights. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the first one to talk about equality, fairness, and justice, honoring everyone, every human being, regardless of their background, regardless of their education and where they came from, regardless of their skin color. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna ilahakum wahid, your Lord is one." وَإِنَّ أَبَاكُمْ وَاحِدٌ And your father is one. So he was the first one. I mean, European nowadays, they brag about, or they claim that they were the first one to establish human rights, which is a false claim. The Muslims in Andalusia were actually establishing rights for animals at a time where next door of other European nations didn't even know what is the meaning of human rights. There is one thing, brothers and sisters, one thing that was incredibly brilliant thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had that caused a lot of people to love him and believe in him. And that thing is that he seemed to have worked in the hearts of people. He worked in the hearts of people, which caused people to believe in him and respect him and hand over the keys of their hearts to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thumam ibn Usal, Sayyidu Ahlul Yamama, a man whose name was Thumam ibn Usal. He was the leader of a big tribe in the Arabian Peninsula called Al-Yamama. This man was caught and brought to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his way to Mecca. So when they brought him to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the masjid, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, كَيْفَ حَالُكَ سُمَامَ قَالَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قَالَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ إِن تَقْتُلْ تَقْتُلْ ذَا دَمٍ وَإِن كُنْتَ تُرِيدُ الْمَالَ أَعْطَيْتُكَ مَا تَشَاءُ وَإِن تُنْعِمْ تُنْعِمْ عَلَى شَاكِرٍ He said, if you want some money out of this, I will give you whatever you want. And if you kill me, my people will come and take revenge. And if you let me go, I'm an honored person and I will never forget your generosity. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَحْسِنُوا إِلَى ثُمَامَ Treat him well. Some of the companions were angry and they start asking each other, this is a man who fought us in battles. This is the enemy of Allah and his messenger. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَحْسِنُوا إِلَى ثُمَامَ Treat him well. The following day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked him again, how are you today? He said the same thing the third day, the fourth day. After a few days, he let him go sallallahu alayhi wasallam. قَالُوا خَلُّوا أَمْرَ ثُمَامَ Let him go. Set him free. They let him go. This man, subhanAllah, he was completely transformed from being an opponent to a lover, a true lover. He came back and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad. He said, Ya Rasulullah, Wallahi, your religion was the religion that I hated the most, was the religion that I hated the most. Now it is the most beloved to my heart. Your name was the name that I hated the most, but now it is the most beloved name to my heart. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam owned the hearts of people. That he put all these qualities in practice and he lived them sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He forgave people. He smiled at people. He joked with them. He cared about them. He helped them. He felt their emotions. He was ready to die for them. He dedicated his entire life for them. And he was ready to even give more. He was concern about the safety of people, the guidance of people. He never thought putting himself above anybody or before anyone. He never said myself. He never said it in this world and he will not say it in the next world. Because as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described unto us, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that she were sent as mercy to mankind. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله, الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما, وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. الحمد لله. Inshallah, before we make the announcement for today, inshallah, there are a lot of people who called, and some people met me after prayer, and they were asking about the celebration of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And I'll be frank and honest with you, 3 or 4 years ago, before I moved here, I decided not to address this question anymore, because I felt like whatever I'm going to say won't make any difference for people. Those who celebrate will continue to celebrate, and those who don't, they will, you know, will follow their path as well. And then I'll be the one who get criticized, but you know, I'm open to that. It's been a decade now, so. Anyways, there are so many scholars, significant number of scholars, great Sunni scholars like Ibn Hajar, like Imam al-Suyuti, like Imam al-Nawawi, and others who are actually in support of celebrating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are others who are not. And the difference comes from the definition of the word bid'ah and how the scholars differ about the word bid'ah. What is bid'ah, what is not? I'm not going to go into that. I'm just going to tell you something very simple. If you celebrate the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first of all, if you have people over in your house, just like you bring some friends, invite some friends over, have some tea and read the Shama'il of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, recite the Burda of Imam Abu Sayri or anything like that, and have a meal after that, then go ahead and do it. That's one thing. The other thing is, if celebrating the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is something that you will do out of your sincere love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, number one. Number two, that you will not go out and tell people that they must celebrate and it's mandatory or even sunnah. The third is that you don't do anything contrary to the law of Islam, then this is the opinion of Ibn Taymiyyah. You can go ahead and do it and you will be rewarded. But if you're someone who is fearful of falling into a sin, you are someone who doesn't go out and call people names, you're kafir or you're mushrik because you're celebrating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you just do not celebrate it. It's your path, it's your opinion, you follow your ideologies or the school of thought that you found. If you think that this is the right thing to do, then go ahead and do it, and you will be also rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is it. We don't really want to drag the discussion out. Inshallah, we'll stop right there and we'll read the announcements. Inshallah, tomorrow, ISUI will host another Meet Your Muslim Neighbors event from 2 to 4:30, inshallah. So please invite your non-Muslim friends, classmates, neighbors, co-workers, and their families. Tonight at 7:15, Brother Ihsan al-Turabi, inshallah, will deliver the final lecture of his talk on the three stages of Islam. Also, the youth group will be hosting Friday Night Live in NPR tonight at 6 o'clock. Next Friday from 12:45 to 5:45, ISOI will host another blood drive, inshallah. Our last blood drive was such a huge success, alhamdulillah. So please plan to spend about an extra 45 minutes after Jum'ah next week to donate. The weekend school and the community assistance program will host a day of service project on Sunday, December the 18th from 9:30 to 12:30 p.m. where volunteers will put together a package for the homeless. There'll be, inshallah, 20 volunteer spots left for children and adults alike. If you are unable to donate your time, please see the posted flyers for the list of items that you can donate. CAB, supporting SCMCO, Toy Drive for Immigrant Kids. You can drop off new toys, only new, please, in a box in the lobby. SMCO will be holding a joint masjid volleyball tournament for immigrant kids, inshallah, and the deadline to register is December the 20th. On Saturday, December the 10th, the Mission Viejo Masjid will host a bazaar from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. All funds will go towards renovating their women prayer area. Tomorrow, Islamic Relief will host their annual gala. Please visit their table outside. Brother Zia is outside if you want more information. This Sunday, inshallah, IMPACT will host its 2016 annual convention. This year's theme is Building Bridges, Breaking Barriers. Let's, inshallah, conclude making dua for everybody. Our brother Sattar Mansouri and sister Zubaydah Salim and Marlene Sanchez and her baby. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them speedy recovery and remove their distress. Allahumma ameen. اللهم اجعل هذا الجمع جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا بعليه تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا حولنا ولا خلفنا شقيا ولا محروما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه في الآخرين وصل عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين آمين 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 سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله استووا الله أكبر اللهم بعد بيني وبين خطاياك بعد بيني مشكور اللهم نقيني اللهم نقي من الخطايا بالماء والثلج والبرد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجلى وما خلق الذكر والأنثى إن سعيكم لشتى فأما من أعطى واتقى وصدق بالحسنى فسنيسره لليسرى وأما من بخل واستغنى وكذب بالحسنى فسنيسره للعسرى وما يغني عنه ماله إذا تردى إن علينا للهدى وإن لنا للآخرة والأولى فأنذرتكم نارا تلظى لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى الأشقى الذي كذب وتولى وسيجنبها الأتقى الأتقى الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى ولسوف يرضى. الله أكبر. سبحان الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه ما شئت. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. تحية الله الصلاة والسلام علينا وعلى آله وصحبه. لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله.
الله أكبر
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we ask His help and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil inside us and from the evil consequences of our bad actions. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no God to be worshipped but Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our master, our teacher, our leader, the Prophet of Allah. Brothers and sisters, love is truly a powerful, unique, irresistible power. And sometimes when we try to express our love, we find it so hard to find the right words. And even when we come up with words and expressions to express these feelings that we have, some of these expressions don't fully represent what do we feel and how do we feel. Some of these words don't fully represent what is burning deep down in our hearts. This may explain why we associate love with actions, not just words. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, إِنَّ الْمَحَبَّةَ لَا تُحَدُّ وَلَا يُذْكَرُ لَهَا تَعْرِيفٌ. He said that love has no definition. Love is this feeling that you have for someone and you're ready to do anything for that person because of that love. That love drives you to do anything to please the beloved. And speaking of love, brothers and sisters, today is the 10th of Rabi'ul Awwal, a month in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. The month of the birth of the best creature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ever created. The birth that gave humanity a cause to rejoice. The month of the birth of the one, the chosen one, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made necessary to all mankind in this world and in the next world. Our need for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this world is more important and is stronger than our need for food, water, and air. Our need for him in the next life is even more crucial, because he will be the first one to intercede and the first one whose intercession will be accepted. The month of Rabi'ul Awwal, the birth of the best human being to have ever walked the earth, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Brothers and sisters, it's traditionally known that there are three reasons for love. Three reasons for love. Al-Jamal, wal-Kamal, wal-Ihsan. There are three reasons of love. Number one is the physical appearance, the beauty. And it's a human nature. When you see beauty, you recognize it. And it's a human nature also that when you see beauty, you get attracted to it. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was described by many people, by many of his companions sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people who grew up with him, people who didn't even believe in him, but they said the truth about him. He was described by his family members, wives, and his children, one of the most beautiful and the most profound description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you'll find it that was told by Hind ibn Abi Hala, the stepson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the son of Khadija radiallahu anha from a previous marriage. But maybe one of us or some of us will think that was just an exaggeration for their love to this man, because him just grow up in the household of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what about someone who just spent a few years with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
like Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, who said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very handsome, كَأَنَّ الشَّمْسَ تَجْرِي فِي وَجْهِهِ. He was so handsome, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as if the sun was running across his face. Maybe he's also exaggerating, because he spent some time with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about a woman who didn't even know that that was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that who is known for all the, for his trustworthiness and his integrity? This is the man that people are talking about nowadays. This is the man of Quraysh. She didn't even know that he was a prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He passed by her tent on his way to Medina. And after he left sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spent only a couple of hours. And after he left sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she told her husband when he came back, she said, "Dharana al-yawmu rajulun dhahirul wada'ah." You know, this man is the most beautiful and the most striking from distance and the most beautiful and handsome from close up. But brothers and sisters, beauty is not the only reason why we fall in love. Sometimes you see beauty but without any substance. Al-Fadl ibn Rabi' was one of the students of Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah. This man, they said he was, his physical appearance was really unpleasant. And so he was asked to meet with the prince, Amir al-Mu'mineen Harun al-Rashid. It was so bad that Harun al-Rashid had to turn the other way. And so this man got hurt. And he said, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, inna Allah lam yujillu Yusuf alayhi salam lihusni manzarihi, walakin likhuluqihi wa husnu adabihi." He said, "O Prince of the Believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not honor the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam because of his beauty. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored Yusuf because of his manners, because of his character, because of the traits and the qualities that he had, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the purity of his heart. As the poet said, لَيْسَ الْجَمَالُ بِثِيَابٍ تُزَيِّنُنَا إِنَّ الْجَمَالَ جَمَالُ الْعِلْمِ وَالْأَدَبِ. He said that the beautiful person is not the one who wears beautiful garments. The beautiful person is the one who has, or the one who possesses knowledge and manners. Knowledge and manners. And so that will take us to the second point, or the second reason of love, which is quality. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was someone who was praised in his quality by the creator of the creation. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. That she have the best personality. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the purpose of his prophethood and the method of his call when he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثُّ لُؤْتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. That I was sent to perfect the good manners. I was sent to perfect the good manners. And because he possessed these incredible qualities himself, it was easy for him to recognize it in others, in people, in Muslims and non-Muslims, people who actually fought him. When they brought him Sumana bint Hatim al-Ta'i, a daughter of a man whose name is Hatim al-Ta'i, she fought Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They brought her, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recognized her from her last name. And he said, khallu sabilaha, fawallahi inna abaha kana rajulan yuhibbu makarim al-akhlaq. He said, let her go, let her go. Because her father was a man who valued good character. Let her go because her father was a man who valued good character. So he forgave sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had these incredible qualities of forgiveness and forbearance and compassion and mercy. And the Sahaba witnessed all of that. The Sahaba saw how he endured patience during the midst of trouble, during the hard times that he went through, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it was easy for a lot of them to adopt his characteristics, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was easy for them. It was easy for them because good qualities, brothers and sisters, good character is contagious. Abdul Fattah Abu Ghidda, Sheikh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon him, a Syrian scholar who studied in Egypt, in Al-Azhar, who died 1997. He's from Halab, Aleppo. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the people of Syria. Allahumma ameen. This man, he said, there are two things that are contagious, diseases and good character. So if you are in a company of people, good people, you'll be able to learn from them. Pick up some characteristics, some qualities, some good qualities from them. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the best personality. He was praised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Aisha radiallahu anha, his wife, was asked about him, a few young people went to Aisha after the departure of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they said, كَيْفَ كَانُ حَالُ النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Describe to us, how was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What is the character or the personality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His character was a Qur'an. The Qur'an, subhanAllah, the Qur'an, when you read the Qur'an, when you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Qur'an, you will realize that the Qur'an is just a love letter from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. A love letter from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us to remind us of the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His character sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the Qur'an. What a beautiful, beautiful description. Which means that he was a Qur'an walking in earth. He was an open book sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the embodiment of revelation. He was in a complete movement towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. But brothers and sisters, having good character without living it, without practicing it, is not enough. And that will take us to the third cause of love, which is a higher cause, that she loves someone لإحسانه, for the way he conducted himself. The way he put these qualities in practice, the way he treated people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And let me put it that way. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala felt pity on the condition of the world, he sent them someone who would improve their misery, remove their distress, release them from the problems that they had, worry about their guidance, forgive their mistakes, fight for the oppressed, speak out against the oppressors. And that was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He turned his people around in an unbelievably short period of time. He took them from being polytheists to being monotheists. He took them from disbelieving in life after death to living a life where everything is directed toward the next life. He took him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from a tribal nomadic culture with no law or the law of the jungle to a society that governed by principles of equality, principles of justice and fairness. If you like to read history, read the status of the world in the 6th century or the 7th century before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will know the great need of humanity to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the first man in the history of mankind to articulate the principles of equality between men and women. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the first man to lay out the foundation of human rights in the history of mankind, something that the European claim that they were the first one to establish that, which is a false claim. It was a false claim. The Muslims in Spain, the Muslims in Andalusia, they were talking about the rights of animals in Islam, when other European countries next door didn't even know the definition of having human rights. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the first one who laid out a foundation of human rights. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the first man in the history of mankind to establish a constitution where every single person, regardless of their background, regardless of their culture, their religious background, their religious belief, their ethnicity, every single one of them shared the same exact rights as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the rest of the Muslims. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put that personality in practice, brothers and sisters. And there's one real thing, which I consider to be the key to success, to the success of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That incredible, brilliant idea or way that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam adopted, which is working on the hearts of people. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seemed to have worked on the hearts of people, which caused people, made people love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to respect him and hand over the keys of their hearts to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thumam ibn Usal, Sayyid Ahl al-Yamama. There was a man, his name was Thumam ibn Usal, was the leader of a big tribe in the European peninsula called al-Yamama. This man was captured, was caught, and was brought to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his way to Mecca. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him and he said, Ya Thumama, kayfa asbahta ya Thumama? Kayfa asbahta ya Thumama? Qala Muhammad sallallahu ala Muhammad. Qala Muhammad, in taqtul taqtul dha damin, wa in kunta turidu al-mal a'taytuka ma tasha' wa in tun'im tun'im ala shakir. He said, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you want money out of this, I'll give you whatever you want. But if you harm me, if you kill me, I have strong lineage, I have a big tribe, they will come and they take revenge. And if you let me go, if you set me free, I will never forget your generosity. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم احسنوا الى ثمامه, treat him well. The sahaba of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, they start to question each other. This is the enemy of Allah and his messenger. We should just get rid of him. But Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, احسنوا الى ثمامه, treat him well. The second day Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he asked him the same thing and he said, أحسنوا إليه, treat him well, treat him well. The third, the fourth, a few days later, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, خلوا أمر ثمامة, set him free, let him go. Ya Rasulullah, this is the enemy of Allah and his message. This man fought us in battles. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, set him free. This man left, he came back a few hours later, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Wallahi, he said, Ya Rasulullah, Wallahi, laqad kana deenuka abghadu al-adyan ila qalbi. وهو الآن أحب الأديان إلى قلبي. He said, O Prophet of Allah, Wallahi, your religion was the religion I hated the most, but now is the most beloved religion to my heart. Your town, قد كانت مدينتك أبغض المدن إلى قلبي. Your town was the town that I hated the most, but now it is the most beloved to my heart. Even your name was the name that I hated the most, and now it is the most beautiful, the most beloved name to my heart. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, لقد أخذتني خيلك. I was captured on my way to Medina to perform Umrah. Will you give me the permission to perform Umrah? And the historian said that Thumam ibn Usal was the first man in the history of Islam to announce the Talbiyah out loud. He went to Mecca. Before Fath Mecca, before the conquest of Mecca, where Mecca had 330 different idols representing people from all over the Arabian Peninsula, worshiping idols. He went in there and he climbed on the Kaaba and out loud he said, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, Labbaik la sharika laka Labbaik, Innal hamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk. He was taken, he was beaten up. The only person who recognized him with was Sufyan ibn Ibn Harb, and who pushed everybody, he pushed every single one of them away, and he said, don't you know who's this man? This is Thumam ibn Usal. You need this person. You need this man. You get your wheat from his tribe. So he got up and he wiped off the blood off of his face, and he says, Wallahi lan tasilakum habbata qamhin ba'da al-an illa an ya'dhana fiha Rasulullah. He said, Wallahi, you will not receive a grain of wheat from now on unless Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam permits it. And he, subhanAllah, imposed an embargo in them to the point that the Qurayshi, they start eating the skin of the corn. And then they turn to who? To Habibullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they said, we still cousins? We still family? Can you please, would you be able to speak to Thumama? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent to Thumama and he said, خَلِّي بَيْنَ قُرَيْشٍ وَالْقَمْحِ. Send him back to wheat. The reaction of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was incredible, and the words that he said deserve to be written in gold. Something that the modern history, the society that we live in, don't really recognize. We have witnessing people under embargoes, kids, millions of them, died, and more are dying. But when you study the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you shouldn't be really wondering about the traits and the manners and the qualities he possessed sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Simply because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You have the best personality. You were sent as mercy to all mankind. But see, Thumama radiallahu anhu, he was transformed completely from an opponent to a true lover of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This man, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, met after the battle of Khaybar. This man saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sleeping under a tree. He picked up a knife or a sword and he put it on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's neck. And he said, من يمنعك مني? Who will protect you from me? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will protect me from you. Then the man started to tremble, started to shake, and he dropped the knife. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam picked it up and he put it in his neck and he said, now, من يمنعك مني?
Who will protect you from me? But this man had nothing to say. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he put his hand on the chest of this man. And he said that the moment that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put his hand on my chest, he became the most beloved. He became the most beloved to my heart. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was someone that he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to improve people's misery and remove their problems and worry about their guidance and forgive their mistakes. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the first one, as we said, to lay out the foundation of human rights, the first one to articulate the principles of equality between men and women. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right before he passed away sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Hujjat al-Wada', he said, Ayyuhannas, inna ilahakum wahid, wa inna abakum wahid. O people, your Lord is one, and your Father is one. No Arab has a favor over another Arab, no Arab has a preference over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab over an Arab, nor a black person over a white person, nor a white person over a black person. You are from Adam, and Adam from dirt. That was the message that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent to people. And that's how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam owned the hearts of people. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما انفعنا وزدنا علما وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم الحمد لله. Before, inshallah, we read the announcements for today, Jum'ah, I wanted also to finish my khutbah with something that I really decided maybe 3 or 4 years ago not to talk about it anymore, which is the celebration of the Milad, or the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the reason that I decided 4 years ago not to address it to the community anymore is because what I'm going to say will most likely won't change anything. Those who celebrate the Mawlid will continue to celebrate, and those who don't, they will also follow their path. But I've been asked lately for the last week or so, people called here, people sent emails, and I didn't respond to any of them, and I thought, you know, I will just respond here during the Jum'ah. Listen, this is a matter that the scholars differed about. But however, let me just put it that way. If you're planning to have if you're planning to celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in your house where you invite people and have some tea and recite from the Burda or from the Shama'il or Shifa or any of the books about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, traditional books, and then have a meal after that, and you know what, go ahead and do it. Really, go ahead and do it. The second thing is that there are a significant number of scholars who are in support of celebrating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like Ibn Hajar and Imam al-Nawawi and Imam al-Suyuti and great scholars. But I will tell you what Ibn Taymiyyah said, which I think it's really fair. Ibn Taymiyyah said, If you're intending to celebrate the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with, number one, pure intention, out of sincerity, out of love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number one. Number two, that he won't do anything contrary to the law, to the Islamic law. Number three, that he won't go out and tell people that they must celebrate the Mawlid because it's mandatory
If you want to celebrate the Maulid with this intention of your love to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then go ahead and do it. He said you'll even be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you're someone who is fearful, someone who doesn't or concerned about falling into any type of sin, someone who does not go out and tell people you're kafir or mushrik or mubtadi', you're destroying the religion of Islam or the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by celebrating the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you avoid all of that, then you will also be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't want to drag this discussion out. I don't want to go any further than that. You know, again, it's really up to you. So, anyways, this is what I wanted to say about the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, tomorrow Aisha I will host another Meet Your Muslim Neighbors event from 2 to 4:30. Inshallah, invite your non-Muslim friends, classmates, neighbors, co-workers, and their families. Tonight, inshallah, at 7:15, Brother Ihsan al-Turabi will deliver the final lecture of his talk on the three stages of Ihsan, of Islam. Also, the youth group will be hosting Friday Night Live at the NPR tonight at 6 p.m. Next Friday, inshallah, 12:45 to 5:45, ISOI will host another blood drive. Our last blood drive was such a huge success, alhamdulillah. So please plan to spend about an extra 45 minutes after Jum'ah next week to donate, inshallah. The weekend school and the community assistance program will host a day of service project on Sunday, December the 18th from 9:30 to 12:30, where volunteers will put together packages for the homeless. There will be still 20 volunteer spots left for children and adults alike. If you are unable to donate your time, please see the posted flyers for the list of items that you can donate. CAB is supporting SCMCO toy drive for immigration kids. You can drop off only new toys, please, because people have been dropping off all kind of toys, all toys. Only new toys, please, in the box in the lobby. SMSCO will be holding a joint masjid volley tournament for immigrant kids as well. Deadline registers December the 20th. So Saturday, December the 10th, Mission Viejo Masjid, inshallah, will host a bazaar from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. All funds will go towards rejuvenating their women's prayer hall. Tomorrow is, he just told me after the first Jumu'ah. Next week, inshallah, next Saturday, Islamic Relief will host their annual gala, inshallah. Please visit their table outside. Brother Zia is standing outside for more information. This Sunday, Impact will host its 2016 annual convention. This year's theme is Building Bridges, Breaking Barriers. Inshallah, conclude big dua for everyone. Brother Abdul Sattar Mansour, Sister Zubaydah, Khanoum Salim, and Sister Marlene Sanchez and her baby. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them a speedy recovery, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove their distress. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ja'al hadha al-jam'i jam'an marhuma. Allahumma ja'al hadha al-jam'i jam'an marhuma. Wa tafarruqna min ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'asuma. Wa la taj'al fina wa la hawlana wa la khalfana shaqiyan wa la mahruma. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل عليه في الآخرين وصل عليه في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. Oh Allah, we ask you to honor us as you honor the righteous people before us. Oh Allah, we ask you to have mercy on our parents and bless our children. Oh Allah, we ask you to bless and protect the Muslim community in Irvine and all Muslim communities and all communities and protect our country. Allahumma ameen. آمين آمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت
الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوى الصغير ورحمنا رحمكم الله الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إن المتقين في مقام أمين في جنات وعيون يلبسون من سندس وإستبرق متقابلين كذلك وزوجناهم بحور عين يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة آمنين لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا الموتة الأولى ووقاهم عذاب الجحيم فضلا من ربك ذلك هو الفوز العظيم فإنما يسرناه بلسانك لعلهم يتذكرون فارتقب إنهم مرتقبون الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام